Dopamine is perhaps the most well-known happy hormone. It's responsible for motivation, drive, reward, pleasure, cravings, and many other functions. Dopamine plays a vital role in our pursuit of goals and directly impacts our quality of life. So, if you want to step out of your comfort zone and do something new, dopamine becomes crucial. In essence, if you want to break free from the couch, stop binge-watching Netflix, and take action, you need dopamine. There are two ways to increase dopamine. I call them the quick and dirty way and the right way. Let's begin with the quick ways of increasing dopamine. Consuming chocolate, at least to 1.5 times increase of the baseline of dopamine. Nicotine causes a 2.5 times increase. Sex results in a 2 times increase. Other activities such as drinking alcohol, shopping for some people, watching porn, or playing computer games also trigger dopamine release. While engaging in these activities can stimulate dopamine release, the problem lies in the fact that they provide a temporary dopamine hit followed by a significant drop below the baseline. So, you enjoy a dopamine-heavy state for a moment, but you pay for it later. These activities tend to have a neutral effect on the dopamine levels. That's why I call them quick and dirty ways. There's nothing wrong with this as long as you clearly understand the trade-off. Personally, I engage in such activities quite often. For example, when I need an extra push to complete my work, or motivate myself to go to the gym after a long day at the office, I drink a small cup of coffee and eat some chocolate. Sometimes I overuse these methods. Actually, it's not sometimes, actually very often, but I'm working to address that. On the other hand, the right way to boost dopamine involves efforts that have lasting effects, such as achieving something fulfilling or making a positive change in your life. This approach leads to a sustained release of dopamine. Dopamine levels rise when we achieve something, when we're in the process of achieving something, or even when we're planning to achieve something. Planning is my favorite. Achieving something requires effort and takes time, right? But it takes only a minute or two to start planning and transition from a lazy, apathetic state to an energetic, dopamine-rich state. Just to clarify, this is not mere planning for the sake of planning, but rather planning as the initial step towards achieving something remarkable and significant. My typical approach to overcome that lazy, apathetic state starts with the planning process. When I'm planning achieving something, I already get a dopamine boost and excitement. Then I compile a list of action items, complete one or two of them, cross them from the list, and experience another dopamine boost. All this leaves me feeling empowered and energetic, and ready to rock. Here are a couple more good ways of increasing dopamine, through exercise and exposure to cold temperatures. Both methods can raise dopamine without subsequent crash. And I really like both. I exercise regularly and always take a cold plunge after using the sauna. One note, since our channel's focus is on health, I encourage you to prioritize the right ways of boosting dopamine by achieving or trying to achieve something significant in your life or engage in regular exercise. Understanding how to get a quick and dirty dopamine spike to improve your mood and happiness is also valuable. But use those spikes responsibly. And a few more interesting points about dopamine. Engaging in activities you enjoy leads to an increase in dopamine levels. So the old saying, do what you like what you do, holds true, since it provides an easy way to boost dopamine. A more fundamental point to consider is that in order to have a reliable and long-lasting supply of dopamine, it's important to have a life mission, a life purpose, or a significant goal that truly excites you. For example, aiming to achieve an A in a challenging class, finishing a marathon, or winning a Nobel Prize. Different people have different goals, right? The process of working towards and achieving this objective can provide a significant dopamine boost. Additionally, it's worth noting that dopamine co-releases glutamate, an exciting neurotransmitter, and dopamine is also involved in the production of epinephrine or adrenaline. Therefore, a peak in dopamine can result in a peak of adrenaline, leading to a surge of energy. Finally, there are times when it's better to do nothing instead of actively trying to boost your dopamine levels. This is especially true after experiencing a significant dopamine increase triggered by a specific event or an activity. Let your dopamine levels to return to the baseline. It's important. Dopamine, like other neurotransmitters, naturally returns to its baseline level. Engaging in a period of dopamine fasting prior to seeking to enhance your dopamine levels again can be beneficial. If you're interested in learning more about dopamine, its pathways, the mechanics of dopamine release, and other fascinating aspects of dopamine, I recommend watching Andrew Huberman's video on dopamine. Or if you prefer reading, The Molecule of More is an excellent book on this subject. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If you know someone who may be feeling down, please share this video with them. Our goal is to help them reach a happier state. If you enjoyed this video, please give a like to us and a dopamine boost to yourself. You can also leave a comment such as all respect to Swiss for the discovery of dopamine in 1957. It will help our small channel grow. Stay strong, stay healthy, and be happy. See you next time. Bye.